Impotent. Meghan showed monster face as hated every second of pointless Australia tour. After thousands of people showed up to grab a glimpse of her at the Opera House in Sydney in 2018, Meghan Markle reportedly says she saw no purpose in the tour and didn't understand the arrangements. Despite the smiles at the time, Meghan Markle hated every second touring Australia in 2018 with Prince Harry and said the visit was pointless, royal sources claim. The visit, a time-honoured royal tradition dating back to 1867, saw the Duke and Duchess of Sussex spend nearly 2 weeks in Australia, New Zealand, Tonga and Fiji just one day after announcing their first pregnancy. At the time, the tours hailed a success with huge crowds turning out eager to see the newlyweds. Now former Vanity Fair editor Tina Brown has spoken of Meghan's true feelings 4 years ago in her new royal biography The Palace Papers. She despised the tour. She quotes a palace worker as saying, as they visited Sydney, Melbourne, Dubbo and Queensland's Fraser Island before going to the Invictus Games. The employee told the author, "So, Meghan must have been thrilled with it all, right? No. She apparently hated every second of it. She didn't understand why things were set up in that way. Instead of being excited when thousands of people showed up at the Opera House, it was very much like, what's the purpose? I don't understand this." Meghan didn't appear to understand the representational role of the British monarchy, the palace staffer said. Speaking to Last Year, another source said the former Suits actress didn't get it when thrilled crowds showed up to welcome her and Harry in Australia. The insider claimed that upon seeing hordes of fans waiting outside the Sydney Opera House, Meghan said to the team, "What are they all doing here? It's silly." Speculation has been mounting about whether Meghan will return to the UK in June for the Queen's Platinum Jubilee celebrations. Harry said he did not know if he and his family would come to Britain to mark the event in a recent interview on US TV. However, last week it was reported that Harry's aides are making plans for him to be by the Queen's side to attend the Platinum Jubilee. One source said, "Harry is certainly in favour of going, so naturally plans are being put in place for him to make the trip should he want to confirm. There is the issue of security and the ongoing court case which needs to be sorted out. Previously it was a red line for Harry, but there might be a resolution in the offering. Everything will hinge on that, but Harry loves seeing his grandmother and wants to spend time with her and his family." Meghan Markle, 40, family series Pearl was dropped by the streaming platform on Sunday as it reviewed animated content. Dropping several projects, including Ms. Markle's, was part of strategic decisions on the production of animated series, the company said in a statement, without providing further details on its decision. Royal biographer Angela Levin has since claimed Meghan will not listen to advice from others on future projects. Speaking to Talk TV, Ms. Levin said, "You can't just use people for your own ends. You actually have to approve things when a lot of money is concerned with a big company. They're not stupid, they're only going to wait so long. They've been incredibly patient and they've decided that along with other things to just cut out the trash, really. What you're seeing and being shown, but also Meghan won't take advice. She thinks she's knows and that's the trouble. She's very proud and it's all gone to their heads." Archie Productions, the company formed by Markle and her husband, Prince Harry, said last year that she would be an executive producer of Pearl. The series was to be centered on the adventures of a 12-year-old girl who is inspired by influential women from history. Harry and Meghan signed a multi-million pound deal with Netflix in 2020. The news that Pearl is being dropped comes after it emerged that Netflix lost 200,000 users over the first 3 months of 2022, falling well short of predictions it would add 2.5 million subscribers. Netflix has stumbled in the face of increased competition from the likes of Disney, Amazon Prime and the reopening of cinemas. The US firm has seen its share value cut in half over the past 6 months as investors have grown increasingly concerned by the change in fortunes.